Hey, it's Maren, and this is the weekly astrology and tarot forecast for Sunday. What day is it? Sunday, January 19th through Saturday, January 25th. So we will get started first with the tarot spread. We'll do a Celtic cross to see what energy is all coming up for us collectively, situationally. Then we will look at the daily astrology to see really how this is manifesting particularly and round things out with some guidance from the oracle decks. So first thing, I'm just going to be using my good old Rider-Waite-Smith tarot deck to pull out 10 cards to describe the situation at hand. Interesting, definitely a predomination of wands cards this week, at least from first off. So we'll get started here with the first card at hand. And the card representing kind of the situation as a whole is the Two of Cups. This is generally referring to an early budding relationship or interpersonal matter that is not complicated. It is this like innocently new bonding that feels really good and easy. The second card is a complement that we have to that is the King of Wands, which is someone who is going after initiating a project. They're dramatic, they're willful, they're fiery. And it can be a kind of impersonal energy of someone kind of just doing things wildly. But in this case, I think we have met up with someone in some kind of a relationship where they're very much like an alpha, assertive figure that we are letting get things done. The third card representing the potential for the situation is the Three of Cards, which reversed here has to do with possibility turning something good into something bad, overdoing it, or not following what we know is our best intention. This person might be trouble. The fourth card is the unconscious reason for the reading, and we have the Three of Cups this time, and the Three of Cups is definitely a card where there's like an awkwardly cold party dynamic going on, like no one is really talking, it's kind of distant. So we might have just come out of a situation in a relationship where like the other person was just like not getting it. The recent past represented by the fifth card is the Six of Pentacles, which is a card of worldly success. It's literally called success as a card. It deals with having the material success that you need to be celebrated and stable in where you are. The future represented by the sixth card is the Two of Wands inverted, which generally feels like instead of you going after the world is coming after you. So the future of this dynamic doesn't look too worth it. The seventh card is us in the situation. We have the Empress, who is the card of Venus. She is luxuriating in worldly sensory pleasures. So we're feeling really good right now. Like we're probably a bit high in the new stage of our relationship. The eighth card is our influences and environment. And with the Four of Pentacles inverted, we might be overwhelmed by tasks that we need to delegate. Like we need to delegate some things going on so that we can enjoy this even more. The ninth card is our hopes and fears, and we have the Lovers. So I think there's a real possibility of this turning into a more permanent relationship in whatever this is, whether this is business or romantic, but we have to be sure that we are ready for the consequences with this person, which honestly don't look too hot. The 10th card is the outcome, and we have Judgment, which makes so much sense because this is a fork in the road. This is a decision that will take you on two separate paths, whether you choose this relationship or not, knowing that if you do continue with how, if you follow your feelings of being like on top of the world right now, there's a good chance that there will be a ton of turbulence to work through. You have to decide if that's worth it. So with this being pretty clear this week, let's look at the astrology day to day. So starting out on Sunday the 19th, we were woken up by the moon in Scorpio sextiling the sun, which definitely stabilizes our internal world and external self-projections a bit so that we are solid in ourselves and how we want to present ourselves. And the moon enters Sagittarius later that day, which definitely uplifts our spirits immensely from what started out on Sunday. And the trine to Chiron opens us up to untying our emotional knots, so we might feel close to this person just because we have been emotionally intimate with them, maybe not because they hold our best interests. Monday the 20th, the sun enters Aquarius, which moves into another Saturn-ruled sign, but the sun in Capricorn is more, or Capricorn as a sign is more top-down boundaries of like, how can I exclude, whereas Saturn through Aquarius is more bottom-up boundaries of how can I include. So there is definitely a more inclusivity to the sign of Aquarius in the fixed air sign, and a Moon-Mars conjunction in Sagittarius might agitate us a bit about that newness, while a Moon-Neptune square confuses us about what we're upset about. There seems to be some agitation, but some, like, I don't even know what's going on-ness also. Tuesday the 21st, the moon is void in Sagittarius for most of the day, which illuminates explorative yet unpredictable energy for Tuesday, so definitely a wild card during the day. The moon does enter Capricorn late Tuesday evening, so if you're awake, sobriety will quickly set in, reminding us that we must solidify structures that support us here and now. I think Tuesday is a wake-up call for we might be feeling on top of the world with this person, but does it support our long-term interests? Wednesday the 22nd, the Aquarius sun will sextile Chiron and Aries, which allows us to bring in some opportunity to warm up our colder logical self with some openness and vulnerability. The Moon-Jupiter conjunction in Capricorn reassures us that we have the energy to take things slow and steady even when we feel pretty somber, while the Sun-Uranus square might have us questioning the changes that we must take in order to enact that. Like, we feel we know what's in our best interest, but we feel a bit worried about how much that's asking of us. Thursday the 23rd, Venus sextiles Jupiter, start out our day with just enough softness and harmony to surprise an otherwise serious current season. So it might feel like it's everything against the world right now. Like, it might literally be like this one person is the only light that I feel in my life, therefore the world is cold, when that might not be the full picture. The moon joins Pluto and Saturn quickly to make things real life and quickly, and the dramatic crisis is here now, so deal with it. Like, the end of this week really highlights this fork in the road of, are you going to choose this person that's tempting but maybe not worth it or definitely not worth it, or are you going to deal with the feelings of somberness and sobriety by yourself to see what that's asking? Friday the 24th, the moon enters Aquarius and squares Uranus, which jolts us into acting quickly and spontaneously to suddenly recalibrate the morning. So there is a decision made, I think, by Friday. The new moon has both the sun and the moon tightly squaring Uranus, so expect the expected unexpected. So with this new moon on the 23rd to the 24th, basically, depending on our time zones, this is a much needed refreshing cool drink of water after an insane boxing match that was the last eclipses. To learn more about this new moon, you can watch my video all on it down below, much more in depth. But basically, the co-presence with Mercury and the square to Uranus means that we are feeling the emotional and intellectual fears of feeling the fear but doing the thing anyway, and setting new limits in the forms of intentions, not parameters, to keep ourselves small. A new beginning is being asked of us, and that might have to do with choosing the colder yet more sustainable option with this relationship. Finally, Saturday the 25th, there is a Moon-Mars sextile to provide opportunity to say what we need to say in an honest, concise manner. So by the end of this week, we are saying what needs to be said to this other person in a grounded, mature, yet direct way. The moon sextiles Mars and conjoins Mercury, which highlights this decision as pivotal for today. So do the thing and trust your inner truth. Make the difficult decision rather than taking the easy way out that is not going to be easier in the long run. Now let's look at the Work Your Light Oracle deck cards to see what's coming through as some guidance. Ooh, this had some difference and some context into what's happening. So for the head card, we have boundaries. Where do you need to establish better boundaries? Maybe logically, it's more about making a decision to enter this relationship or this dynamic with clear boundaries about what you are expecting so that you aren't taken advantage of. For the body card, we have Lemuria, creating heaven on earth, it's happening. Making sure that you are creating a physical situation in your life that honors you. Like, don't repeat past discomfort. Make this physical situation comfortable and illuminating. And finally, for the heart card, we have yes. Just say yes. So what is your heart telling you? Not your excited lustfulness, not your logical head of weighing out good or bad. What is your heart telling you? That might be more complicated than yes or no to a person. So with that out of the way, let's pull a Law of Attraction card to see what attraction guidance is coming through for this, like, kind of attraction-based week. We have, I do not need to monitor my thoughts. Rather than trying to monitor your thoughts, pay attention to how you are feeling. For if you should choose a thought and not in harmony with your broader intentions, you will feel the discord, and then you can redirect your thought to something that feels and therefore serves you better. So this really is a week of listening to your heart, taking the fork in the road that your heart is calling for, that you can tell is in your best interest, not in what the logical mind thinks will be of like the most pleasure. Because you can't know that. You can just feel in this moment now. So let me know down below what this is looking like, because I'm honestly like really interested in how each of our situations this is manifesting. I'm excited to see how this manifests like collectively. Check out my readings down below if you like this. I do offer readings in astrology and would love to read for you. Otherwise, like, subscribe, do all the things, and I will see you in the next video.